Welcome to the 6-5 on the road for the HPE GreenLake announcement at the Hewlett-Packard Enterprise new global headquarters in Houston, Texas.
Hi, this is Pat Moorhead, and we are here on the new HPE campus here in Houston, Texas. It's great to be here, and we are going to be talking HPE GreenLake services, storage, and data. Gentlemen, thank you so much for being here. I mean, we are face-to-face. Can you believe this?
It's great to be here.
Yeah.
Nice to see you, Pat.
Yeah, good Daniel. To see you.
Yeah, it's good to see both of you, Tom and Omer. 6-5 on the road here at the headquarters. Kind of cool because it's not actually open yet.
I know.
It's coming up really soon.
We're getting a sneak peek.
We're in the sneak peek. And of course, we always have fun. You know, we saw San Jose open up. Now we're going to see it open up here in Houston. And as a couple of Texans, you know,
right,
relocated, but both from Austin, we love seeing HQs of tech coming to the state of Texas. So this is great stuff. Tom, Omer, welcome to 6-5 on the road.
Thanks.
Pleasure to be here.
Yeah, a lot going on. Some big announcements just made. You know, let's start there. Let's jump in. You guys ready?
Absolutely.
Okay, you're at the edge of your seat.
Yeah.
So
ready to go.
You know, you guys had a bunch of big announcements. Tom, I'm gonna start off here with you. You know, give us the recap of the stuff that's, you know, under your particular purview.
Yeah, great. So really what we've been talking about today is the kind of the introduction of a completely unified HPE GreenLake cloud platform. Fidel Maruso joined us recently to get that into full production. Really what's exciting for storage and data in today's announcement is we've introduced a complete new block storage service, HPE GreenLake for block storage, as well as a significant enhancement to our backup and recovery service, SaaS service on the platform as well. You know, if you think about really the, you know, what makes it special, what makes it neat is these are, you know, we bring a true cloud operational model to the customer. It's not just a UI in the sky. It's really how you have roles and personas, and you have IT admins that can do certain things, and normal line of business DBAs can do other things just like they would at a hyperscaler. So really exciting to bring out these two new services today.
Now, this is excellent. And maybe we can kind of dive in on differentiation. You know, we've seen, I guess for 12 years now, kind of storage as a service in the native cloud folks. And then what we're seeing with addition to HPE is a lot of people are jumping on the bandwagon,
yes,
right? And so I want to make sure Omer, you know, and Tom, you both have to answer this question. What makes it different? How's it different? How's it unique? What are the incremental benefits that you bring to the customers?
Sure, yeah, you know, I guess, as you said, imitation is the sincerest form of flattery.
I inferred it, yes.
But if you look at what we've done, we've taken a tech stack that took us probably 5+ years in Aruba to get it to its current state, right? So 120,000 customers, you know, you've got millions of devices around the world. You've got 1 billion events an hour coming in, being ingested by the platform. This is a battle-hardened platform that Fidelma took and made really cross-company useful. So we have a tech stack that is, you know, takes a while to get there, a lot of investment. Particular to the block service, and then I'll hand it off to Omer here. We didn't bring out just one grade of storage. What we brought out was both our mission critical 100% data availability line of capabilities, as well as our mid range kind of 6.9s business critical. So really any workload. And what really makes it different than the cloud is the cloud does not have that level of availability or performance in any offer today. I don't know, Omer, maybe you can pile on here.
No, 100%. Yeah. So a couple of things I want to start off with, you know, as Tom mentioned it earlier, it's a battle-hardened tech stack. But the thing that I want to specify and actually focus on is that it's not hardware leasing. A lot of the offers outside of the public cloud for storage as a service are essentially the same hardware stack, but you sort of pay by the drink. It's a leasing model at the end of the day.
Right.
But once you think about bringing a true service to the customer, I mean, yes, obviously storage admins are going to use it, but literally it's for everybody, right? From the procurement of the service, which is two clicks, very simple attribute-based rate card that you would see at, for example, at any hyperscaler. From that point onwards, the entire experience of ordering, providing your commitment levels, and then consuming the service is completely, click next, and then the gear arrives, dials into the cloud, registers on the cloud console, as Tom mentioned, and the cloud operational model then just takes over. So not only pre-buy, buy, and then operate N plus one operations are extremely simple. It's just taking the same hyperscaler simplified model, but now adding the availability levels, adding the performance levels to the particular service, depending on the SLA that was purchased, and then on the customer goes. And from a customer perspective, it's great if you have storage admins, but if you don't, anybody can order, use, and then consume the service, just like a cloud service, with benefits that it now sits in your own data center or at a service provider of your choosing.
Yeah, it is funny like how some people might minimize the importance of having even a web portal that looks similar to what they're used to. But if you've had somebody who's maybe been buying storage for 12 years from a cloud service provider, that's actually a benefit. And then you get into the management of it. And it's funny, we always use the word single pane of glass, which mm-hmm. is more like it's just minimizing panes of glass, right?
Right.
I'm not aware of any enterprise who has one pane of glass, right? But it's really minimizing it. So I do like the approach that you've taken. I looked at the portal just to kind of see what it looked like, and might people understand this? And I think it's a good step forward.
Yeah, a lot of the improvements have actually been made by bringing the cloud operational model for our customers. So it's like a cloud that comes to you.
Yeah.
Once the appliances land, from that point onwards, there's essentially just two cables, power cable and a networking cable. And then the cloud, you can onboard it through the cloud. You could be sitting on a beach somewhere, and the appliances will be onboarded, and you can just start to configure and partition storage just like you would do in a hyperscaler model. The second biggest advantage that customers have actually told us that have ran previews with this particular service is the amount of usage analytics that we can then throw back to the customer. And because we can bring the power of InfoSight, we have been in that business, so analytical storage business, for about, 10 years now. Marrying the two together to bring the operational model and the analytical model back to the customer really makes this block storage what I call the application context aware. So traditionally, customers have always been dealing with LUNs and volumes with no real indication of what the actual storage sprawl looks like. So to be able to map that back with InfoSight analytics and take it back towards the workload that they're running and sort of displaying that entire stack from an analytical perspective really, really makes the sort of day N plus one operations very, very simple for the customer.
And we get some really good customer feedback, critical reports to add. Look, I have to run this kind of quarterly or monthly capacity report. I owe my, my auditor. I have to. It would be really, really nice if we could make sure that we have the ability, across the entire data state, map it back to say line of business tag, or map it back to line of business comma workload comma user kind of tuples. So the ability for people just to run reports, look, here's your chargeback for this month, here's my capacity report. So there was a lot of thought went into not just a zero touch deployment, but really what it means for someone responsible for the gear to do kind of their typical stuff that would be in an Excel spreadsheet, or in the back of a, maybe in notes on their iPad, but actually just have it automated on the console. And then, of course, as we said, just like with EBS or any other cloud service, you can have personas that are allowed just to, instantiate a volume, delete a volume, snapshot it, freeze it, those kinds of things. So really that separation, that end-to-end separation of duties, that end-to-end, really thinking about how we drastically simplify where people are spending their time with storage on premise. We think we've you think we've really moved the state of the art forward?
I think there's a really interesting opportunity for HPE to lean into the data services side.
Yes.
As your legacy tends to have people think about big iron, you know, big storage. And as we're seeing the data and the compute and the services all moving closer together, that GreenLake story starts to make more sense. What you guys are building starts to make a lot more sense because you need all that data. It needs to be accessible. You're seeing very much software-defined type of data infrastructure being put into place so that all data is more immediately accessible for machine learning, for acceleration. And of course, you're seeing new companies come into the market, and you guys, as an on-prem slash cloud that comes to you, I know there's some different ways you guys like to explain that, hybrid architecture opens up the doors to partner with some of these software companies to make sure data maximization is in place. I mean, you guys did a fairly elaborate partnership last year with Splunk, and that was a good instance of where, you know, two companies coming together to solve a big data problem for a massive, I believe that was Wells Fargo, and that's public, right? So I can talk about that. You guys kind of answered my question, because I was going to ask you about what this means for customers, and frankly, you guys hit that question really well. So I want to move forward and just talk a little bit about data protection. So, you know, we're seeing this exponential data growth. We're seeing it from edge to cloud, which is the underpinnings of your narrative. But we're also seeing enterprise, government, all the customers you serve they're all on the defense. Everyone seemingly is under attack. It's not an if, it's a when. Data protection is in focus. What is the HPE approach to provide some comfort and help customers deal with these challenges right now?
So there are a couple of ways we're attacking the problem, right? So along with the block as a service, we've also announced significant enhancements to backup and recovery service, which is the GreenLake backup and recovery service. So we're taking it out of preview mode. So it was running in preview mode for about 3 months with some introductory customers of ours. So now we have added the capability of, you know, backing up any virtual machine using GreenLake backup and recovery service. So now it's applicable to almost all forms of storage that the customers may deploy. The number one thing that we have focused in there, is again the service experience, right? So data protection, as you well know, it's a painful field, right? Nobody looks forward to backing up mountains of virtual machines and mountains of data, right? So when we fundamentally looked at the experience, we noticed that, you know, media servers and catalog servers have a huge sprawl, managing, patching, nobody looks forward to that. Then in addition to that, when you go into data protection appliances, or what we call backup targets, these sometimes range in petabytes in nature, right? Lifecycle management, maintenance, patching, upgrade, lift and shift, is just the amount of painful labor that goes in that, along with backup management, is just excruciating for customers. So what we looked at both of those and said, how can we bring the cloud operational model to the data protection world? And that was the birth of GreenLake Backup and Recovery Service. So what we have again done from the unification console that Tom mentioned on the GreenLake platform, it's really as simple as going to the GreenLake platform, you type in your vCenter address for your virtual machine environment, could be anywhere, and from that point onwards, the console just takes over. We shoot down our proxies, which are completely cloud managed. The customer doesn't have to touch it. And boom, we start protecting your virtual machines. And the chargeback just starts at that point. No media server management, no data backup target management. They're all included in this particular service. Lifecycle management and a full 3-2-1, you know, on-prem, cached, and cloud protection is complete turnkey as part of this solution. So that's just on the backup side. And then, as you know, we were fortunate enough to bring another company called Zerto into the family. And that they're a leader in disaster recovery as a service. And one of the biggest facets they bring to the table is ransomware protection, because they literally simplify and revert you back to seconds before when the ransomware attack took place. Right? So bring both of these together for backup and disaster recovery as a GreenLake cloud package is now available for our customers.
That's exciting stuff. And, you know, so I don't know, maybe Tom, I hit you up any closing comments. I'm sure, you know, what I get the question a lot of is, hey, this storage as a service thing, you know, how do I get started? Kind of what do I need to be thinking about? Maybe you can take us out here.
Sure. So you know, it's you go to the GreenLake console. Create yourself an account, and from there, you're off and running.
When he was talking about it, though, you saw Tom kind of got a little smirk, and he was just smiling. You could tell he was proud. He was feeling good about what you guys are building.
I'm sorry, you caught me with a private joke between us because he's like, Tom, three clicks, you're protected. That's right. And I'm like, okay. And so I looked at a competitor in the market, and they had a 126-page quick start guide. And I went, okay, you win. You proved your point.
Will read that. Just so you know, as a millennial, I can say that.
But really, it's about getting yourself a GreenLake account right from there. Off the portal, you can start to specify what you would like. You pick some attributes, gear shows up, and away you are off and running. We had for several months a preview of the block service out that people were able to go and go take a peek at. Again, got some really good feedback on that. But we're trying to make this as simple as possible.
Well, you're doing a good job. I mean, three clicks, compelling. You know, we'll have to listen. Our job as analysts, we'll be listening to the street, listening to the CIOs and enterprise executives that are rolling this out and saying, is it as easy as Tom and Omer told us? But I doubt you would come on and say it if you didn't believe in it. And by the way, like I said, congratulations on, you know, the momentum of GreenLake as a whole. I think the data services is a really big opportunity. It's probably an area that HPE can be known even more for, through whether that's through your own services, through the acquisitions you've made, or partnerships that you're rolling out into market. But one thing we can all agree on, data is exponential. And the impact of data from edge to cloud, every business has to be thinking about it, thinking about architecture, thinking about protection, safety, security, and of course, utilizing it to get the best insights, to be able to deliver the best services to your customers, and of course, taking care of your infrastructure in-house. Gentlemen, I want to thank you so much for taking the time
with us.
Thank you.
Tom, Omer, thanks for joining 6.5 on the road. Congratulations on the big GreenLake announcements. And by the way, beautiful facility here in Houston.
Is.
If you're out there and you're working with HP, I recommend stopping by.
It's almost a modern art museum.
If you like modern art. So, gentlemen, we're signing off now. Thank you so much. We'll see you again soon.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.